everyone. Welcome to my channel English Literature 101. The topic for today is a poem titled The Kite, written by Harry Benn. This poem is prescribed by CBSE for class 6 in the English book named Honeysuckle. Before starting with the detailed explanation of the poem, it's very important for us to know something about the poet. So the poet of this particular poem is Harry Benn. Harry Benn is both an American screenwriter as well as children's author. He was born on September 24, 1898 in United States. His notable works are The Big Parade 1925, Hill's Angels 1930, The Faraway, Lars 1963. So without any further delay, let's move into the poem. Well, we all love to fly and see kites flying, isn't it? But have we ever noticed the way it flies or the way it looks when it flies? So basically in this poem, through the words, the poet Harry Benn creates a beautiful picture of a flying kite. The poet through his words and imagination power persuades us to also take a minute look into the movement of a kite. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. So here the poet says that the kite when it's new or during its first flight looks so beautiful, pretty and vibrant in the blue. Here blue refers to the blue sky or the clear sky. So he says that the kite which flies in the sky looks so beautiful, vibrant and pretty when it's new. With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail. Now what does the poet say? The poet says that the kite with a swiftness as well as with a softness in its movement, the kite creates a snap or we can say a cracking sound in the air. So basically in the first four lines he says he admires the movement of a kite which is so vibrant, so beautiful, so swift and so soft and it looks so good in a blue clear sky. Then soars like a ship with only a sail, as over tides of wind it rides. The movement of a kite is compared to ship with a sail. Just when a ship or a boat catches wind and the wind makes the boat or ship move forward, similarly the kite also soars high with the wind. Climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. So here what the poet says? The poet says that when the air current or wind is strong, the kite rides on air just as ship rides on the waves of the ocean. And similarly, when the wind falls, the kite also comes to rest. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows and its wings fill and up it goes. So what does the poet say here? The poets say that when the thread which is tied to a kite loosens, the flyer, what does he do? He runs again and rolls it back. So the flyer then waits till a new breeze blows again and again it fills its wings with air and make it fly high once again. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new, but a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. So here again the poet repeats the starting lines of the poem, isn't it? But the difference is that in the earlier lines the poet talks about the beauty, the movement of the kite, but here in the last four lines we find that the poet mentions that state of a kite when it gets stuck on a treetop and gets raggeder, which means it gets torn or tattered and is worn out, giving it a look which is not liked by anyone. So the look of the kite that was praised in the earlier stanza is all changed as the poem progresses. So if we put the whole thing in a nutshell, we can say that at first the poet praises or admires the beauty of the kite and its movement. Secondly, he compares its movement with the sail of a ship, which becomes strong with strong air current or wind and comes to rest when it falls. Thirdly, he gives us the image of a boy or a flyer who flies a kite. He rolls the thread when it gets loosened and waits for the next breeze so that the kite can fly high. And finally, the poet gives the image of a kite getting stuck on a treetop, thus losing its beauty and turning itself as an old, worn-out and tattered kite. Here I have provided a list of new words along with their meanings, which will be helpful for better understanding of the chapter. So guys, that's all for today's video, and I hope you all have understood the poem well. If you have any queries regarding the chapter, do let me know in the comment section below. And please don't forget to like, subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for further updates. Thank you.